We can stop the rain. Welcome to Decent Life. I'm Lou Pugliafito. The call-in number is 212-245-7273. 212-245-7273. The guidelines for calling in are is to lower the volume on your TV or computer so we don't get any feedback. Listen to the phone and not the show because, you know, we're on an 8-second delay, which means I'll be trying to talk to you, then I'll be hanging up and you'll be calling back. All right, and if you like, the first name, your first name and location where you're calling from. And as you see tonight, we have a guest, and I think one of the best guests I have in a while, even though they're all great. But the program that she founded is Pajama Program, and we'll get into that. But this is Genevieve Piturro. Genevieve, nice to meet you.
So nice to be here, Lou.
Hey, it's great. Based on the shows you've been on, it's an honor for you to come here.
I love it.
Appreciate that.
Thank you.
Before we get started, just give us a little bio of your background and how you got into starting the Pajama Program.
Sure. You know, I had no intention of ever starting a nonprofit. I would give, I would volunteer, but I was working in corporate America, climbing the corporate ladder. That's what I wanted to do from the time I was in middle school. I remember wanting to be working in Manhattan, be vice president of something one day. And I was working in Manhattan, loving it. Working in corporate America, working in TV syndication, but various jobs.
Something was missing.
And it wasn't until I was in my middle 30s that I realized, I stopped and I asked myself if this is enough, if this is how the rest of my life would be, is it enough? And I realized I was missing kids in my life. Mm-hmm. And I said I could read in shelters. Let me call around and see where I could read at night. And people were welcoming, and I went into some shelters and waited for them to bring children in to sit with me and I could read them a story. And they did, and it was lovely. I loved it. I didn't know anything about the kids, but I knew they loved the attention and loved the stories. And one night I saw where in the shelter the kids were sleeping, and it broke my heart. There were just cots and futons, two or three at a time on a bed, nothing to change into. Mm-hmm. And I asked the woman who was working there if I could bring pajamas the next time. And she thought it was a great idea, and I was excited, so I brought pajamas the next time.
Right.
And after I read to the kids, I started handing out the pajamas from the plastic bag I had. And most of the kids took the pajamas and loved them. One little girl wouldn't take them, and she just looked at me, and she just shook her head no every time I tried. She wanted to watch me give them out to the other kids, and she did. Finally, when it was just her, I knelt down, and I said, "Honey, don't you want these? They're for you. They'll fit you. These pajamas will fit you." And she looked at me and she said, "What are they?" And
oh my
she
goodness.
Was a little 6-year-old. And she looked at me and she really didn't know what the word pajamas meant. She had never had them.
She just wear her
slept
clothes?
Slept in her clothes. It were too tight, were too small, were soiled. And it broke my heart. And I couldn't get her out of my mind. And everything changed from that moment on.
That's interesting. So how did you, make that jump, though? I mean, at first you were just doing it yourself, or?
I was just doing it myself. Yep. I would spend a lot of money buying pajamas and books every week, and I would go to the shelters, mm-hmm. and I would read, and I would hand out books and pajamas, and I loved it, and it was becoming more important to me over the next weeks than what I was supposed to be doing, what I was responsible for in my job to a boss. And I was getting calls from people who were working in the shelter saying, "Can you bring more? Or can I give my friend who works in another shelter your number?" And I wasn't saying no to anybody. And I was doing more and more of this on the side, secretively, and less, I had less and less of a passion for the climbing the corporate ladder that
That's
I wanted
right.
so badly.
That's right, because, when you're young and you just had you take what media tells you how you were taught, to be successful,
right,
you got to climb the ladder.
Right. Motivated and wanting to succeed.
Yeah, and then you start to think about, well, maybe succeed means different things.
Right.
It doesn't mean, getting on top of the corporate world, getting all this money and things. It's just this other intangible.
Right. At the end of the day, what do you have?
Right, exactly.
To show for what you did all day.
Right.
And like you said, when you, as you get a little older, you do start to think about, is this it?
Yeah, what the heck am
it's
I doing here?
It's less fulfilling every year.
Right. So, did other people call you to say, well, "I want to help out"? How did you get everybody organized? Was it people call, "Hey, Genevieve, I heard that you collecting pajamas and stuff. How do I help?" Is that how word of mouth first started?
Yeah, going? after I begged my friends and family to help me and give me money and for every holiday, Christmas and my birthday and anything, and just to give me pajamas and books. And because it's such a simple idea, people felt that they could do that. They could give me new pajamas and books. They could give me a little cash to buy some more, because it was simple.
It's not a controversial thing.
No, it's not a big thing.
Yeah.
If you have $10, you can participate.
And
then people wanted to come with me to see the kids, my friends, my family. And when they came, they were hooked. And then, people started telling people, and I would get calls from both people who wanted to help and people who needed, who ran shelters.
And
that's
how we got, but
word of mouth.
But your website, really, I really like what you did on the website, is because, you always tell everybody, you need a good night's sleep to have a good day. Right. And here in your...
Yep, it's right front and center.
Right front and center is, oops.
Yes, good days are good. Good nights are good days.
That's right.
It's so true. We, even for us as adults, how we go to sleep at night really translates into how we feel when we wake up.
Exactly.
And these children have so little in the form of emotional comfort. The clothing, the clean pajamas, that's one thing that's very important for these children. But the emotional component that we take for granted, that our parents gave, you're a grandpa. When you tuck your little grandchildren into bed, you're not just making sure they have warm clothes that are clean and a storybook to read. You're giving them stability, a foundation. They know you're going to be there in the morning, that you're going to be back tomorrow. Everything is going to be okay because you're there for them.
Right. It's a way to help to connect. Because children need to connect, yes.
It's a bond, and you're giving them the self-esteem. You're giving them love and comfort they will have in the morning.
Exactly. And plus, the reading's great, too. Even though, when the kids are a little bit too little, they don't listen, but it's the connection.
Yes.
You're sitting there, and they might be looking at pages and crumpling them up or whatever, but it's still
okay. And for these children that we see, their life has been, in some cases, horrific. Right. And the fantasy of a storybook takes them away from what's keeping them awake at night, their nightmares and their anxieties. Mm-hmm. If they have a pretty book to look at, even if they can't read, even if they're still alone when they get our pajamas and books in a shelter or anywhere they might be, that book may take them away from the bad horrors.
But
temporarily.
I got you, but still the bonding is great, too.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. It's great, and they don't have it.
And what was interesting, as we were talking offline, is that everybody has the idea of little children, but there's actually teenagers that you support as well to make sure that they have a good night.
Right.
Which I thought that was terrific, because everybody thinks, oh, little kids.
Right.
But you can't forget about
preteens and the teens, because they understand life a lot more than a little 3 or 4 year old who you know is easier to cuddle and to comfort, and they'll be excited about a pair of pajamas and reading with them and a new book that's just theirs. But the teenagers, they know that they're alone. They know what's happened in their life and that it may not get better, and it takes a lot more and a lot more kindness to remember.
The
bigger kids, and so we don't want to forget them.
And also, I was looking at your site, but I'm not sure if it's the main reading centers.
We have reading centers, yes.
So you came from going to the shelters and pajamas and books, and now you have reading centers as well?
Right. We have 63 chapters in the U.S. where we have boots on the ground giving pajamas, doing fundraising, and doing pajama drives and book drives, and giving them to those places we've vetted in those cities. And we have over 3,500 places we give around the U.S. But we have 4 reading centers. So it's in Manhattan, which is our headquarters. We have a reading center in Yonkers for Westchester, in Red Bank in New Jersey, and our newest one in Atlanta, Georgia. And that's where we bus in children in groups to come and read with our volunteers, have an hour escape, a field trip to a really wonderful new place that is full of loving volunteers who give them undivided attention, read with them, let them pick a book, give them a pair of new pajamas and a little ceremony where we call out their name. And they feel so special. And that's what we all want to feel. And these kids rarely get that.
Okay, so for feeling. The one in Manhattan, since it's this is a local show, what's the address of the
East 39th. It's 114 East 39th. We love volunteers. We need volunteers. And we have kids come every day.
From different shelters and...
Yeah, different schools that need support.
Oh, so there's no limit you have to come from a shelter. It's schools.
No, it's all the children that are... We cover in our mission statement. All children that have a right to this good night that for several reasons don't have that kind of a good night that they do have a right to that we take for granted.
Right. And going back to the good night stuff, I see you have a Bill of Rights.
We
as
do.
Well.
Yes. Yes.
And can you just, summarize?
Yes, sure.
So, so basically what you're saying is, right, to have stability, security.
Right.
Have the feeling of being loved and cared for bed. And they have a fresh, clean pair of pajamas that they feel comfortable in.
Right. Okay. Our executive director, Jamie, is an attorney.
Uh-huh.
And she called up one night when she was on our board, a president of our board, and she said, how about something like this?
Okay,
with her
attorney
background. And I loved it. And so we worked a lot on how many should we have, 10, what? But we came up with these five that are really the core of what every child has a right to at bedtime. Because these children don't have it, and there's no reason why.
Right. And just because the child's not in the shelter doesn't mean that they have it.
Right. There are a lot of children who may have a parent or both parents who can't take care of every need. There are children in schools that have free lunch programs and need support. So we have different groups that need our help, and we vet them and...
Okay. Just to interrupt, if you have a question for Genevieve, it's 212-245-7273. Mm-hmm. 212-245-7273. I know all of you are sitting out there saying, wow, what a great program. But you know what? You also could go to the website, volunteer,
that'd be
donate.
Great.
Yeah. And I hear that you have an upcoming event coming up soon.
We do. We have our annual benefit in New York on May 10th. And information is on the website. This year we have a special message. It's not just the fall or the winter when it's cold that these children need our support. It's all year because
exactly.
of their circumstances.
Yes.
So we want everyone to know that all the seasons are important for us to maintain the help we're giving nationwide to these children.
And I see Carla Hall is going to be there.
Carla Hall is a board member. She is great, yes, from the CHU. Yes.
Okay, so...
A wonderful chef.
Yeah, have some great eats that night.
Yeah, and she makes our event a lot of fun.
Yeah, that was... That's. And you know what, too, is that I mentioned about the show, John, but you have it basically, because, you know, it's a simple thing, and nobody's against pajamas and books, and that you got such wide recognition. And if you don't mind, I just want to play that one little piece from when you went Oprah, right? Back in 2007,
yeah.
was it?
Yeah.
That was, I was surprised about, well, let's just show the clip.
I never thought of this before until I heard your story. I never thought about the kids right here in the United States in foster care who don't have a pair of pajamas. And so we challenge this audience to pay it forward by bringing as many new pajamas as they could to the
I know the best hour of my day
32
is spent
hours.
With my girl.
32,000 pairs of pajamas.
That was a shock.
Wow.
As you can see on my face.
How did you get those home?
A shock. with a lot of help from Oprah and all her people. That was an incredible, incredible day.
And that exposure must have really, along with other shows that you've been on, to really get it, it started to snowball.
Yeah, they call it the Oprah effect, and that's what it is.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I saw some of you, the partnerships that you have with Carter's.
Carter, Scholastic, Target, Bob's Discount Furniture, so many, wonderful, giving companies and individuals, foundations. It's great.
And to me, it's amazing with Bob's, because you see the commercials on TV with Discount Furniture, you would never link him to there.
Very generous company.
Which is terrific. So you know what? Go on the website and, you know, support the companies that support, Pajama.
Carter's and Scholastic do wonderful fourth quarter promotions for us. Like I said, Target's been great. Bob's has been great. Yeah. Wonderful.
Yeah, there's, you know, there's always, let me just go back to the events that you had. Are there any more upcoming besides the annual gala?
We're doing a walk in September in Manhattan. That's a lot of fun.
Okay, this
so it'll be.
It's not,
be,
is
it's
it
not on
yet?
The website yet.
Oh, it's not on yet.
Oh, you know it says pajama walk on the left. Well, that was probably this year over the Brooklyn Bridge. This year coming in September, we're doing it on the west side on the pier. So there'll be information, or you can certainly email us or call New York and find out about the September Manhattan Walk, which is a lot of fun. Walking in pajamas, it's a family event.
And you know, I just,
that's fun.
I just put up a couple of pictures of you having so much fun with the kids. You know, it's,
you know, there's nothing better.
Look at those smiling faces.
It's so simple.
Yeah.
It's so simple, and we take it for granted what that bedtime is and what it really gives children.
Yeah.
Especially these children.
I don't want to get off topic, but still, it's not just that, but also a lot of families have lost eating together at meals, especially dinner. Everybody's so working, so maybe we've got to work something out on that.
Yeah, but for all of us, families, it's how important it is. But still, and so it's nice because so many men are putting their children to bed at night. And
it is,
grandparents.
Yes.
And it's important.
Yeah, and especially not about men. I don't think how many people don't realize that children need both parents.
Oh, yeah.
They need that father figure in there.
Yeah.
Because what I noticed when I donated my time and work with children, I was always wondering why they would focus on getting recognition from me, because they need that father figure in their lives. So out there, you know what, if you have children, you know, dads, go out there.
Absolutely.
Don't shirk your responsibilities.
Yeah, dads, grandpas.
Grandpas, too.
Yeah.
But you're right. Now, this day and age is a little bit different. I think some people are realizing, you know, that mommy works now, daddy made me stay home, and that as well, which is... Okay. So let's go back to the fundamentals. So good nights, good days, imagination. So how does that fit into with the imagination?
Well, again, for these children, nighttime is a scary time. They don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. They've been moved around without notice. They don't have much of their own that they have when they get torn out of one place that they thought was home, taken to another place. And the bedtime and the story time, whether they're being told a story, sitting with someone, or with a book in their lap all them to themselves, even if they can't read, they start to look at the pictures. They start to listen to the story. Their imagination opens up. And maybe they think about what different kind of life they might have when they grow up. They think about maybe they could be a ballerina. Maybe they could be a firefighter. Maybe they could be a policeman or a woman. Maybe they could be a rocket scientist, an astronaut. Maybe they could be a teacher. And their imagination starts to move in a way that's freer because they're looking at pictures, they're hearing a story. And maybe there's a little spark that stays with them.
Right.
And they remember it and carry it with them till the time when they might say, hey, I remember that story, and there might be something in that. If I want to be a teacher, I remember that teacher in that book.
Oh, a lot of kids want to be firefighters and policemen.
Boys and girls.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's this.
So that imagination needs to be fostered in these children because they are just sad, depressed, stressed. Yeah. And they don't need to be. They're children.
That's right. And there are people like that. And to volunteer is amazing how it changes your life. Mm. I knew when I was approached when I was working at New York Life by the foundation, hey, can you come out? Who wants to do this? I'm too busy. Mm-hmm. But once you get started, it changes your life and you're hooked.
Yes.
So how can our viewers come out and help, whether donations or volunteering?
There are different ways to help. Certainly, we need volunteers at our reading center in New York. And we have a website. You can find on the website where to look at the schedule to see where you can sign up. Certainly, you can call for information or email us for information on being a volunteer. There's a quick background check online. It's not a involved.
Good. Okay, but you know, you still need the background.
Absolutely.
You know, too many pedophiles.
We just want to make sure that we know who our volunteers are. So once you pass the background check, you're cleared to come and volunteer, and we can tell you more about that if that's how you want to help. You can certainly do a pajama and a book drive, all new pajamas, all new books for children of any age. Mm. You can celebrate someone's birthday by having a drive and asking friends to come with a new pair of pajamas and a new book to give to Pajama Program. We can help you with invitations. There's artwork you can use if you'd like to do something fun. And anybody can do it. Children can have a pajama and a book drive. Yeah. Adults, we've had 80-year-olds have parties where they've asked their friends to bring new pajamas and new books.
So,
and donations of cash of any amount as well.
So there's different ways to participate. And you could start off slow, volunteer, and then actually be a facilitator or a leader of an event or something like that. If that's the right way to put it.
Yes, certainly people have their own fundraisers for us.
It's great. And I just want to pull this up again because I can't believe it. You have 780 volunteers in the reading center?
Yes. Well, and we have at least two readings every day, and that's at least 20 children in each reading and 20 adults. We like to do one-on-one. So we have lots of readings and lots of children and volunteers. So.
Okay, so and on the website, even a shelter, whatever, if they're watching the shelters, contact information. Well, they just pick up. Everything's on the websites now, so you can figure out where you want to go. But I still want to know is, you're checking out everybody. So good. Why are you doing this show? Because, you know, you didn't check out Decent Life.
Well, if you were with the children, we would have to give you a background check. But I'm a big girl. I don't require a background check.
Okay. Well, we talked a lot. And I just want to summarize, you know, or maybe you want to summarize, you know, just in a couple of sentences, do we miss anything of importance? Or the main thing is we have to connect with our children.
Yeah, the main thing is we, Pajama Program, is committed to doing this. We do it every day, all year. Like I said, the seasons are very important. The children need our help. Summer, spring, winter, fall. They need the support. Not only do they need the pajamas and the books, and they have to be new for hygiene reasons, and the books new too, because they never get anything new, these children.
That's right.
And so we think that giving them new pajamas and new books is a good thing.
And on a selfish thing, it'll make you feel great.
It does.
I'm telling you, look how happy she is, all right? And me too, when I volunteer. So
it does.
Please
do. It changes volunteers' lives.
Yeah. So we need to increase the number of volunteers.
Right.
Nationwide, right? 63 chapters out there, which is terrific. Nothing overseas yet, just everything here.
We do share when we get a call from somewhere out there, anywhere in the world that, where there's a shelter. We have helped and we've not ever said no. So we will share what we have when we can.
That's right. Yeah. And if anybody has an idea, you see, you know, you start small, you work at it until it becomes your full-time job and you love, and then you can change the world. You could help people love more than what you want to, because that's what it all is. It's about how
connecting with each other and supporting each other. Yeah. That's all we want to be, connected to each other. And
this is a great story. And so don't be put off. Don't put obstacles in your way. If you have an idea to help, do it. You know, and if you need help, you can give me a call.
Give me a call.
Give Genevieve a call if you need some guidance on starting your own.
Yeah, want to brainstorm some ideas?
Yeah.
I've been there.
I know, exactly.
I'm still, I don't have the answers and I still get stuck, but working with other people and talking and brainstorming other ideas helps.
Because you never know. You facilitate and you never know how many people that you touch. And
yeah,
hopefully we touched a few people tonight, because I know that your program, since I looked at it, it touched me a lot. And we'll see how we can work something out later. But
I know,
Genevieve, with the way you feel and how you do, we can stop the rain.
And
all we need is love. Thank you, Genevieve.
That's
Genevieve.
Okay,
Genevieve, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you, everyone, for watching.